I'm Tanya Burr and I play Ella. Ella is this wildfire, amazing girl who, as soon as I read the play, when I read the play, I didn't know which part I was going to be auditioning for. But I fell in love with Ella straight away because she's not your typical likable character, but she just has so much kind of go get him. And you do feel, I don't want to spoil it for people, but you do feel for her at the end of the play. And she basically is this girl who has a really tough life and she is lacking affection in her life. And she decides, she has no money either. Sorry, I feel like that's important to say. Money's an important theme in the play. And she decides she wants to get out of there and she decides to go live in Hollywood. And she wants to buy a plane ticket to LA and that's all she wants and thinks that's going to make her happy. Not to get on the acting scene, but to go and steal rubbish from celebrities' dustbins and then sell it. She just thinks that's going to make her life better. Turns out, she ends up scheming, manipulating every single person who offers her a friendship throughout the play, and she rejects them all when what she really needed was them. I think I just really was willing to give myself to this role, and I've worked with an amazing team of castmates and crew, and the director, Rob, has supported me so much, and he's given me the confidence to really be Ella and completely embody her. And I couldn't have done that without the support of everybody else, and that was how I got through the really kind of moments where she is more vulnerable in the play. And it changes from night to night. Sometimes you'll find if you come again, like tonight I ended up, you know, crying at the end, but that doesn't happen every single night. Do you know what? It's so funny because I was just talking to somebody else and she said that she'd followed me really closely and like my Instagram and my videos I put on YouTube for the last kind of 3 years. So she's really seen when I started seeing an acting coach as an adult. And obviously I had drama lessons and went to an art school when I was little, but getting back into it when I was 24, 25 was definitely... It was a tough decision, like whether I should do it or not, whether it was worth it, whether I thought I would be able to make it as an actor. But it was just something that was so important to me and I was so passionate about, and I just really felt like I needed to give it a go. So I went and got trained and went and did as many like theatre workshops and workshops at the Actors' Centre and things like that as I could. And the great thing for me is that it hasn't really been a transition. It's been something that I've been really open about with my audience over the last few years. So they've been able to see that really I've got two jobs. I've been training as an actor and auditioning all the time, and that's almost a full-time job in itself, as well as creating content online and sharing little snippets of my life on the internet. And it's actually now moved to the point where acting's taken over and I am making less content online. But I'm not considering leaving the internet anytime soon. And it's a really important platform that can do some amazing things. So I'm really proud of that and I love it. And I think if you look at tons of actors these days, you can see them as actors and influencers because they have huge profiles online. We are on until June the 16th. That's our last show. A few nights are sold out already, so people should get their tickets quick. And they should come and see the show because it's fun. I mean, everyone was laughing in there, weren't they? It was great. But also it has a really poignant message, and it's great for young people as well. The message to young people is amazing. I don't want to give any spoilers, so I will just say it's really worth seeing.